Welcome, and thank you for joining me for Sanctuary Sunday School. Today's subject is Jephthah's answer and vow. Now, Jephthah is not exactly what you would call your ordinary hero. He was not expected to be a hero. As a matter of fact, he was an outcast. They had cast him out of his own land because his mother was a prostitute. They thought he was nothing, and nobody wanted to be bothered with him. But it's funny how things change. The entire territory of Gilead had been invaded by the Ammonites, and they did not have anybody to fight them and drive them out of their land. So now they came and got this outcast, Jephthah, and they asked him to lead them in battle. Now, naturally, Jephthah's response was not all enthusiastic and patriotic. He's like, well, why'd you come to me? You know, you don't like me. I'm nothing. So why are you putting this battle in my hands? So they went back and forth. And finally, Jephthah just said, you know what? If I lead this battle and if I win, will you make me the ruler over all of Gilead? And the elders agreed to it. Now, there's some speculation about why they actually agreed to it, or if they intended to go through with it, or if maybe they thought that he would get killed anyway, that he was disposable. But nonetheless, they made this agreement with Jephthah, and that was his answer. I will go and I will fight this battle. If I win, I will be the ruler over all of Gilead. That's Jephthah's answer. Jephthah's vow. Now, to me, this is perhaps one of the saddest stories in the Bible, because Jephthah was clearly a man of valor and courageous, and he knew how to fight. And he also even knew enough to touch God and get God to empower him to win this battle. But he was clearly not trained in how to entreat the Lord and how to deal with the Lord and how to live righteously, because his vow was not the vow that a righteous man would make. He told the Lord that if you allow me to return home from battle victoriously, then I will offer the first thing that comes out of my house when I return from war as a burnt offering to the Lord. So he came home victoriously. God gave him the battle. But then his daughter was the first person to come out of the house to greet him and honor him for winning the war. And you know how when your kids do something and they think that you're going to be happy because they're doing something for you? Jephthah told her, he said, you have brought me low, because he knew the vow that he had made to the Lord and that he would have to sacrifice his own daughter. Now, we know that God does not honor or endorse human sacrifice in any way, shape, or form. But that's all that Jephthah knew. He did not know how to pray and how to go to God and how to live righteously and how to get the blessings of God without doing those types of things. The heathen nations practiced human sacrifice, and that's all that he knew. So he did sacrifice his daughter, and he was able to get the victory and go back to the leaders of Gilead and rule that territory. There are so many lessons to be learned here. The first one is that God is all powerful. And I know that I say that in almost every lesson, but it's so true. That is what the message is that this entire Sunday school unit is trying to reiterate, that God is all powerful. And all you have to do is obey him and do what he says. And you can go to him and ask you for whatever you want. You cannot negotiate with God. You cannot bargain with God. You're not on his level. All you can do is obey him and ask him, and then he gives to you. And so when we look at this and what Jephthah did, it wasn't necessary. And that's not necessary for us today. Sometimes when you try to negotiate and bargain with God, what you get in return is not worth the sacrifice that you make. And it almost destroys your life. And I look at today, people are sacrificing so much. They're sacrificing their integrity. They're sacrificing their honesty just to achieve a worldly position or worldly gain or money. And it is not worth it. And you cannot win when you do it that way. You may win and you may achieve your goal, but what you lose along the way is so not worth it. God is a just God. All you have to do is go to him and ask him. And I also learned another lesson from the people of Gilead about having a respect of person and not treating people right and outcasting people. You know, we don't have the right. No one on earth, if you are a human being, real flesh and blood, you do not have the right. You are not in a position to judge or banish or outcast anyone. The word says that all have sinned and come short of the glory of God. That does not mean that we have a right to just keep sinning and keep doing wrong. But what it does mean is I cannot think that I'm better than someone else who is still stuck in their sins. And that's the lesson that they had to learn. The very person they discarded as being nothing, the very person that they did not want to be a part of their territory, ended up being the person who saved them and ruled their territory. And that's a very valuable lesson. Even Jesus himself, he came and he was humble and he dwelt among the people and he helped the people. He didn't walk around saying, I'm God's son. I don't want to be bothered with you. I'm not going to talk to you. I'm better than you because I am spiritual and I'm Christ. He didn't do that. He walked with the people and he helped people. And if we're truly saved, that's how we will treat people. There are so many self-righteous church people. And, you know, sometimes church people condemn people who don't go to church, not realizing that the reason why they don't go to church is because of people like you. We have to love people. We have to embrace people. And that's even what this entire Global Sanctuary Sunday School is all about. I want to reach that person who was sitting at home and the church doesn't want them. Their parents doesn't want them. The school doesn't want them. The job doesn't want them. They're not smart enough. They're not educated enough. They're not classy enough. They don't have enough money. Yes, you're enough. You're enough because God created you. God created mankind. And all you have to do is call on your creator. See, I might not like you, but I didn't create you. Therefore, I can't stop you. Therefore, there's nothing I can do with you. Call on God, your creator. He knows you. He knows all about you. He has everything that you need. Call on God. Answer his call. Listen to what he says. Obey him. Make a vow to the Lord, not a vow like Jephthah's vow. Study his word and learn his ways and make a vow and a commitment to God. And you won't ever have to worry about anything because God's got it.